It's another video about the Nikon Z6 and raw video versus N-log versus just shooting a regular profile like flat. Just the other day, Jordan Drake over at DP Review TV did a video talking about the Nikon raw video. And I don't really think he gave it a fair shake. And I don't know if his information was accurate or not, but I'll kind of explain what I saw in that video and what I did reading up on it. So in that video, the quality of the video wasn't that good. He shot raw video, he had a light in his face, and he had a very bright window behind him. And they used an older lens, not one of the newer Z focusing lenses, which are fairly sharp. He talked about the video quality. He said that there's line skipping or line binning with the video, and that it just the raw mode was kind of disappointing. Well, I went ahead and did some looking online about the line skipping that he was referring to, and I found an article on EOS HD, and then it took me to a forum, and then the forum there were a few guys pontificating about this, that, and the other thing, and their testing methodologies. Now, whether they're right or wrong, and if the Nikon Z6 does have line skipping, fine, or pixel binning, I'm not sure what the difference is, but apparently they're both really bad. So today, I'm gonna show the raw video, which I think is probably the best, compared to N-log, which I haven't shot in since I got the raw video, because why would I, but let's try it out. I've never been happy with raw video, with the N-log profile, or how I can even grade it, but I've never graded it in Final Cut Pro 10, so maybe it'll be better. And then we're gonna shoot the flat profile, all recorded with the Atomos Ninja 5, and just see which one looks best. So, at the end of this, I'll show all three side by side, and then I'll post what I think is the best, and then we'll leave it open to your comments. One last thing I will say, I have found that when I'm shooting raw, there's so much information that in order to get the best video on YouTube, I'm having to export as ProRes and upload to YouTube in ProRes, which gets to be a very large file. All right, so what you're looking at here is the raw. All I did was set a custom white balance. Next, we're gonna go ahead and look at N-log. I'm not going to move the camera position. It's amazing that N-log does crop, but another thing I want to test is the video focusing capabilities, because before the upgrade, I remember N-log being atrociously slow, and the RAW seems quite usable. So let's do one of those tests that people love to make fun of online, which is how well does this thing focus on a close object? So, bam, right here. Focus right here. Oh, maybe it was too close. All right, so raw video. Focus right here. Okay, you know what? That's not bad. Just have to make sure they can't see my face. Yeah, and then once it focuses on something, I can get fairly close with it. So what I did here is I kept the exposure exactly the same. This is the N-log profile. I haven't moved the tripod. I'm not sure if this is cropped in more or not. And like I said previously, I just haven't had any good luck with N-log. Maybe today will be different. So before, the autofocus was terrible in N-log. Now with the newest firmware, let's see if it's better or not. So let's just try the same old test with the remote. First thing, here it is. Get my face out of the way. This guy's focusing there just fine. Oh, I lost it. Well, maybe we better hang on. Here's this. Focus there. Let's see, kind of back here. Okay, this isn't seeming too bad. Maybe they fixed it with the newest firmware. Again, let's focus on a product. Get my face out of the way. Get closer. Back to me. Okay. Is the N-log looking better than the RAW? Is it looking just the same? Now, one thing I do like about the N-log is I don't have to deal with Final Cut Pro. I can actually use my PC behind me and DaVinci Resolve, which is my preferred editor. I just actually like the PC better for editing, believe it or not. Let's So one more focusing test. Get my face out of the way. Face away. Right here, focus right here. Maybe it's a little bit slower. But for talking head videos, I think that's probably fine. Okay, here's the last test. I'm shooting this in the flat profile, 10 bit out, directly into the Atomos Ninja 5, and I had to lower the exposure quite a bit just because it seemed a lot brighter than when I was shooting N-Log and RAW. On those, you have to expose to the right. Here, it's kind of like a JPEG. If you blow it too far out, it's not gonna look good at all. Now, I've tried messing with the flat profile before. I haven't been very happy with it. Again, now I'll be editing Final Cut Pro 10. Is this the best way to go? Is this just the easiest? Should I just give up on N-Log? Should I give up on RAW? Or is it worth the extra steps? I'll have a comment here in a minute, but let's test the autofocusing. Same test now. I believe this will be a lot faster than the others. Let's just check it out. Yeah, that already seems more responsive. Oops, whoops, I almost dropped it. Yeah. Oh, it's on my face. Oh, don't look at the face. There you go. Don't look at the face, don't look at the face. Focus right here. Okay, so what have I figured out just from this alone? N-Log, yes, it's slower. I'm not sure why. RAW seems in between this and that. And is flat just the easiest way to go and just grade from there and not deal with the other stuff? Or is it worth messing with the RAW? So let's do a side-by-side and check it out.